Welcome.
Mr. President, I greatly appreciate the warm and generous words with which you have welcomed me to your great country today. It gives me particular pleasure that this, my first state visit, should so happily coincide with the 150th anniversary of the establishment of those friendly relations which have remained constant between our two countries to the present day. That these relations should have stood the test of time, with which constancy is hardly surprising, for our two peoples share common and deeply cherished traditions which lie at the very foundation of our national existence. Indeed, it was these profound beliefs in tolerance, justice, and determination to defend freedom and to uphold the sanctity of human rights which provided the great impulse which brought men from many parts of the world more than 200 years ago in a pilgrimage to this beautiful land to realize their dream of a new life and to found a national which would enshrine those principles forever. Mr. President, over the years, the United States of America has striven unceasingly to make this world a better place for humanity. But nothing you have achieved has surpassed the example of your steadfast championship of those principles, often at great sacrifice and in the face of the most daunting obstacles. I and my people, who have ourselves fought through many bitter years of struggle to maintain our country's freedom, and will do so again should the need ever arise, are deeply conscious of this. For we know from our own experience that peace must go hand in hand with dignity and freedom, that life, if it is to be worth living, can only be founded on justice and respect for humanity, and that these prices are not easily won or preserved. I believe that the world has never stood in greater need for these values than it does today. In recent years, the forces of aggression, intolerance, and lawless ambition have increasingly sought to impose their will on mankind. The world has had no respite from the continuing threat of instability. Nowhere has this threat been more acutely felt than in our own region. of the Middle East, where we and our brother states of the Gulf Cooperation Council have pledged ourselves to work together in the closest accord to safeguard our peoples and our ancient culture. Mr. President, I welcome the constructive understanding your country is showing of the problems which confront our region. And I am convinced that the measures you have taken will greatly contribute to the maintenance of peace and security there. I also warmly commend the endeavors you have made to help bring about an honorable solution to the tragic Middle East situation. Endeavors which, as you know, Oman has unswervingly supported. It is imperative that efforts to achieve this solution continue. Not only in the cause of common humanity, but because so long as the present situation persists, then so long will it present a continuing threat to world peace and provide the opportunity for those forces which exploit the misery and dissension it perpetuates to further their own ambitions. Mr. President, I am sure that my visit will not only serve as a reaffirmation of the cordial relationship that has for so long existed between our two countries, but will further strengthen the mutual confidence and understanding upon which that relationship rests.